Everyone in sales who I know keeps talking about clay. And I want to know, does it live up to the hype? Let's find out.
Here is some clay that I just purchased from Michael's. Yellow, some green. This is oven-baked clay. I'm not entirely sure how this is going to help me sell. I guess we'll find out as we begin to make our model here.
Of course, I'm actually going to be looking at clay.com, the AI tool that promises to scale personalized outreach with better data enrichment. Let's check out this thing and see if it really is a must-have for sales reps, or if it's just another ChatGPT clone with a pretty wrap around it. Let's go look. Import, build lead lists, enrich your leads with over 100 data providers. We've got a free trial here, so I guess I will just do that. Create your first table in clay. So we have the option to find companies, find people, find local businesses, import from a CSV, import from CRM, use a template. Find companies, lookalikes, or a description. All right, so then what we can do is go into, let's say software, employee size, 2 to 10, 11 to 50, 50 to 200. And then I'll just import to new table. Would you like to add additional enrichment? Select all, I guess. And I have some kind of wacky looking clay table here. And now I can add an enrichment. Keep non-text embody, run settings. Only run if, oh my gosh, this is kind of why I put off making this video, because I knew I'd heard clay tables and seen these Excel and screenshots and stuff. And I knew it'd be way too complicated for me because I'm charismatic. I'm good at, you know, talking the talk, having good conversations with people, selling them shit. When it comes to this tech side of things, I know I'm somewhat limited in my abilities. If I'm going to be pretending that I'm selling employee benefits or a HR portal or something like that from like Rippling, then what I would want to do is look for a sign that these companies are not having a good time with their current provider or lack of provider. So if I was in that position, I'd probably go to companies and look at their Glassdoor reviews and look for people who are negatively talking about the benefits or the benefits portal or the HR portal or their payroll being slow. Find companies that I know are going to be facing the problems that Rippling can help solve, maybe even reference some of those negative Glassdoor reviews in my reason for reaching out. With that said, that is a very manual process. Well, it'd be great if I could use clay to scrape the Glassdoor pages of these companies that I'm looking to target. That's what I'm gonna try and accomplish now. And if I can find out how to do that, and I can show that Clay can use AI to make that faster than me going to each individual company's Glassdoor profile and looking through their reviews, then that is a total win. Clay University, shape your learning, Clay 101. Okay, I should have watched this first. If I'm reading this correctly, I can set up a table that has a list of people who were, you know, ICP fits, company size, industry, correct. And then I can add extra filters to find companies that meet a certain criteria using AI that can find anything that's available online. Let's add a column, use AI to look for companies that have negative employee reviews, mention company has bad HR processes or systems. Help me. Generate the prompt. Act as a corporate review analyst focusing on HR processes. Your task is to identify companies with negative employee reviews. Search Glassdoor and Indeed. This is amazing. If it can do this and actually show me results of companies that have negative reviews on Glassdoor, then I've saved so much time, because then I could reach out to one of those companies who has one of those negative reviews and say, hey, I spotted on Glassdoor that it looks like your employees are having some trouble using your HR system to check their pay stubs or submit their benefits. I've heard that this can lead to higher employee turnover or even HR having to get involved more than they would like. A lot of smaller startups are moving over to Rippling because we manage everything all in one place, and it's super easy to use platform for both your employees and your HR team. Something you've checked out in the past, that could be the email. That research to go on each individual company's Glassdoor page would take me hours. If I can use AI to do that, and if it's good, I'm going to find out in a second, then that will be game changing. Let's take a look. Accept prompt. HR complaints. Okay, good stuff. Let's see what happens. Is this going to work? And how long will it take? So from that search, no companies were found. Some reviews mentioned bad HR and negative manager experience. They lack the specific details requested. Some mentioned bad HR. You know what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna pretend I'm a social media manager. I'm gonna add a column. I'm gonna use AI. Look up if these companies are making use of Instagram, TikTok, YouTube. Include how often they are posting on average. Accept the prompt. And we've got 140 credits left. So we'll just run this, because that's the point of these review episodes. So I'll see if I should pay for this after I've reviewed it properly. And now, okay. I'm imagining that what I could do, add a new column, there's how many times they're posting on Instagram, how many times they're posting on TikTok, how many posts on YouTube, but I don't know how. I know it must be possible. Will from the future here, you can do this. It's actually super easy. I just didn't know how. The easiest way to do this when you're making the quote is actually, so let's say add a new column, use AI, and then when you add in your prompt, identify turnover for past year, generate the prompt. But then when you define the outputs, what you can do is add several outputs, negative turnover, and then it'll be yes, no, and then add an output and you can put like percentage turnover. It's automatically gonna peel those out. That's the easiest way to do that. So while you're generating the prompt, input and create new columns for you, if you make the same mistake I did and do the analysis, then what you can do is you text, you can rename that column to whatever you want, edit column, click this little spanner button here, and then formula. You can use AI to build the formula for you. So you click generate formula, it'll build the formula for you. You can check to make sure it's looking correct. Output is correct, save formula. What you get is immediately true, false. Now this will then help you create a secondary list of all the companies who have negative comments that you can then buzz through. Comes time to actually start calling these companies. It's not enough to know something about the company. You want to know something about the people and who the right person is. So then you can click find people at this company, and then you can look for the people with the right titles at those companies. And you can even do further analysis looking for if they're, you know, joining podcasts, if they're posting on LinkedIn themselves, how long they've been in the company, what their title is. And then you could import those into a sales engagement platform and even use AI to write the first sentence of a snippet, you know, trigger template. Back to Will from the past here, while I check out a couple of things in the tool. And if I was a social media manager or a social media marketing agency, I could use that as a reason to reach out to them because they're not posting, or they are posting, or they're not posting enough, or they're posting tons and not seeing much engagement. The possibilities are potentially endless. Oh, I've got an idea. Let's say I sell toast and I'm looking for businesses, and my territory is Halifax, Nova Scotia, Canada. It's not very big territory. I got the short end of the straw there. That's why I'm behind on quota. It's definitely not anything I'm doing. Create new table, find local businesses with Google Maps, coffee shops in Halifax, Nova Scotia, and immediately create a list of these cafes based in Halifax, Nova Scotia. Look through Google reviews complaining that they don't take credit cards. So I like the fact that it uses AI to help you build these. So because that means I don't need to go ahead and do all this stuff, right? Review platform, Yelp, review date, October, reviewer name, Anne B, and specifically mention the business not accepting credit cards. Review point out the inconvenience of payment methods not being accepted, which is closely aligned with the request for payment related. Okay, but there must be a way to make sure that I can like immediately see that. But that's kind of amazing that it just did that for me. And I could leave that running, build a list of, let's just say 100 companies who have negative reviews mentioning payment issues, and then cold call all of them as a rep at Toast and sell the shit out of Toast so they can get a better payments provider, so they can piss off fewer customers and can take more payments and be a more successful business. Boom, Clay AI is cool. I like this. Cool stuff, let's see how much it costs, because if this is expensive, maybe not. Starter for individuals, 2,000 credits a month. It's $150. Worth it, in my opinion, worth it. The $149, I think, is about what I pay for Sales Navigator a month anyway. It has the potential to make LinkedIn Sales Navigator and many other companies obsolete. If you could also consolidate your data intelligence tools like ZoomInfo or Apollo or whatever with this as well, you're gonna be saving money. The only limitation of this tool is the fact that it's fucking complex and scary to look at, which is exactly why I procrastinated on making this video for so long. And I'm glad I finally did it, because frankly, this is dope. This opens up so much more potential for personalization, smart list building, making sure you're targeting the right people. And I would say that's probably the biggest pain point salespeople have today, is that it takes ages to build lists, to create stuff. It's just, it's pretty darn cool. Let me know if you're already a Clay user and if I'm an idiot and things that are really possible with this, because I feel like I've missed a bunch. I'm excited to try more. Peace, love, sales. Ka-ching.